Hi, St. Jude friends. Welcome back. We're here with another art project. So, as many of you guys know, on Friday we are going to be celebrating the May crowning, which is an exciting event because it represents our devotion to Mary and how we recognize her as the Mother of God. So I brought here the Virgin Mary from, you may remember this from my classroom. And here I have made a beautiful crown representing the Virgin Mary. And it's really easy to do. I just used paper towel rolls, toilet paper rolls, and egg cartons. So, see there? That's the crown we're going to be making, okay? So this crown, you can make it small so that you can fit it on. If you have a Virgin Mary statue, you can put it there. Or if not, you could just make a crown for yourself. Okay? So the materials you're going to need are either a paper towel roll or toilet paper rolls. I've used one paper towel roll and two toilet paper rolls for my crown here. If you are going to make it for your head, you would probably need another toilet paper roll. But it's better to have more than less. So just measure it out, cut them out, and then you can see how big or how many more you need to add or less. So you need some rolls. You're gonna need a stapler. I have here a mini stapler. I got it from a little toolbox kit, a little office toolbox kit from New York one time. So I have my mini stapler there. You're going to need some masking tape or scotch tape. You're going to need an egg carton. So your egg carton can be big, small. We're going to use the cups to make the flowers. So egg carton. You're going to need some paint. So I use the blue paint to paint the outside of the crown. And the yellow paint is for the inside where the little flower, the middle of the flower is. But you guys can use whatever colors you have at home. If you don't have paint, you can always use markers. And you're gonna need a pair of scissors. You might wanna use a pencil if you wanna outline something before you cut it out. And then I got here some paint brushes and a paint palette to work on. Let's see. So, I'm also using this cardboard box as a surface because when I paint, it'll just get the box dirty and it doesn't matter. I could just throw it out when I'm done. Also, I'm using this bottle. This is just an empty soda bottle that I'm recycling. And this was used to put the crown around. So you're gonna see after I cut out the crown that it's gonna be kind of tricky to have it facing upwards like this. It's gonna tend to wanna fall or flatten out. So I like this because it's round and it allows me to work around this way when I'm painting it. So you'll see in a minute. All right, so let's get started. First thing I'm going to do is I'm gonna cut my rolls and I'm gonna cut them about an inch. So you can watch me and then follow. First, I'm taking my roll and I'm gonna flatten it out. I kinda want like a leaf shape of the roll. So first I start by flattening it out like that. It's also going to make it a lot easier to cut. And then I'm going to cut about an inch. So just eyeball it. Or if you want, you can take a ruler and measure it out. So I'm cutting my inch pieces. I got those pieces. Now I'm going to cut the toilet paper tubes here. So flatten those out again. Cut about an inch apart. If this is tricky for my friends in kindergarten through third grade, then you guys can always ask your parent to help you cut these out, okay? Or an older sibling if you have one. Alright, so here I've cut all my pieces, and now I'm going to get ready to staple it. So if you notice here, the front of the crown, it kind of comes up. And then around, it's all like the same length. So I'm going to show you how to do this front part first, and then we're going to go around. So you're going to use three of them. So you're going to take one. See, it kind of looks like a leaf shape there. And take the other one and put it right underneath like this. Okay? And then I'm going to staple those right there at the bottom. So take my little stapler. And there we go. Okay? They're stapled right there at the bottom. Then I'm going to take another one, put it on the other side, and staple right there at the middle. So it kind of looks like a lotus flower if you think about it. There we go. Three of them done. Now that's the top of it. Now I'm going to do the sides. So I'm just going to take one and staple it right there on the bottom. Just like that. Then I'm going to do one on the other side. All right, just like that. And then I'm just going to keep going. I'm going to do one on one side, the other one on the other side. And just keep going, keep going, keep going. Remember to staple towards the bottom. I'm folding it a little bit up so it kind of gets used to standing up like this. So one on one side, one on the other side. Whoop. I'm gonna take my bottle now and see how much more I have to go. So I take my bottle, wrap this around, and looks like I need a little bit more. So let's keep going. To refill my stapler. The nice thing about this kit is it comes with also extra mini staples. So this is what I mean when I say it's good to have more rolls than less, because if you just have extra, you can always make a mini crown out of those. But if you have too little, you have to go back and cut more, and it kind of gets a little annoying. So here we go. Okay, last one. So the last one I clipped together like this and kind of looks like a flower. So I'm going to take my soda bottle, put it on there, and have them stand up. Okay. Maybe we could have it stand up this way. Okay, so it looks like my crown isn't standing up properly, so I'm going to start stapling the tops like this. So You can watch me do it first. So take towards the top of those two leaves and staple that like that. And that's okay. Sometimes it's just trial and error. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. You gotta find a new way to do it. It's a fun thing about art. You can always turn your mistakes into creative new things. Use your creativity. So now I'm stapling towards the tops of all those. And let's see if it stands up this time. Yep, looks like it's starting to stand up on its own. See here? Just by stapling the tops together. So, success! Alright. So, looks like I'm done there. Now, let's see if we can fit it on the bottle. Yeah, there we go. So, there we go. We have our crown done. I don't really see the middle anymore where that top was. So, I could always go in and put a flower up there just to make sure that that's like the middle. So, something like that. So, what I'm going to do now is cut the flower out. So we're just going to let this sit over here for a little bit, hang out there. And what you're going to do is with your egg carton, you're going to cut out each cup. So the way that you do that is you just find the section between the two cups and use your scissors to cut that part off. So you should end up with something like this. And then from there, what you're going to do is you're going to start to cut it into four sections. So you may have these two little spiky parts. You're going to cut in between those two. One snip, so it's open right there. Then I'm going to turn it, cut between those two. Right there, just cut that. Flip it over, you may have these two corners here. I just cut in between those. So you should have a total of four sections that you can open up like that. Okay, then after that we're going to cut each leaf, each petal, rounding it out. So for this part, if you want, you can take your pencil and kind of draw a petal. Doesn't have to be anything fancy, just has to be a rounded petal. If you want, you can also use pointy petals, cut those out. Okay, so I take mine and I'm gonna cut it, round it out. So there we go, got one petal there. Let's cut the others. There you go. One flower done. Let's do three more. Let's have four flowers on there. So cut your four sections first, four snips. And again, if you're having trouble cutting these out with your scissors, ask a parent or an older sibling to help you cut them out, okay? There's nothing wrong with getting some help. Thank you. Okay, got three flowers done. One more left. There we go. Cut this up. We go. We got four flowers done. All right. Next thing we're going to do is we're going to start to paint. So, first I'm going to paint the crown. I painted it blue. You guys can use whatever color you have at home. If you don't have paint, you can always use a marker. So, take my blue paint and start painting. And the nice thing about the bottle is, let's say I want to turn it to paint another section, I just turn this thing like a wheel. And it's easy peasy. I'm just going to paint the top blue and leave the rest cardboard. And just for the time's sake. And then I'm going to show you how I paint my flowers and attach them. But you guys feel free to take your time and take this time to relax and paint. Don't worry about what's going on outside or in your home, maybe. Just focus on the paint. I painted all the tops blue, and now I'm going to go into the flowers. So with the flowers, I like to paint the middle yellow. So go in with your yellow paint or whatever you have. Paint that middle yellow. I'm gonna do that to all four of my flowers. Now if you like, you can add more than four flowers. You can make as many as you like. You could even make a crown out of just these flowers. That'd be really pretty for Mary. Then after I go into the yellow, go back into that blue and paint those petals. I paint the petals blue. The reason I use blue is also because the Virgin Mary's color is usually blue. You usually see her in blue. And the reason for that is she represents also the sky. The blue sky and the stars of heaven And you guys know the stars are yellow, but heaven in the sky is blue. Okay, there you go. Got one flower done. Let's do the rest. Okay, I'm on my last flower now. Alright, those four flowers are now done. I'm gonna let them dry really fast. They dry pretty quickly just because they're made out of cardboard. And cardboard is really absorbent, so it sucks all the water out really fast. So you should dry in no time. In the meantime, while these are drying, you can get your masking tape ready. So you just take a little piece, rip it off, and you're going to make a little loop. So you're going to attach those two ends together, making like a little circle like that. Okay, so I'm going to put that on the cardboard. I'm going to do four of these for the four flowers. Okay, three and four. Here we go. Okay, once I've made my four, I'm just going to put them on the back of that flower in the middle there. Just press that on there. And then on my crown, I can put it wherever I want. So if you want, you can put it towards the top like this. That. Let's see, where can this one go? This one will go in the middle there, the bottom there. Let's keep going. I'll twist it around. This one can go here. Beautiful. And let's put the last one on there. You want to kind of fit it in between two of them so it sticks. And then there you go. You have your beautiful May crowning Virgin Mary crown. Okay? I would love to see what you guys make. Please send them over to my email. My email will be in the description box below. And hopefully we can get a lot of pictures so that we can put it on our Facebook page. Okay? Let's try to get these crowns done so that we can post them and the whole school could see them. All right, I would love to see what you guys make. So I hope you guys have a great Wednesday, and I hope you enjoy this project. All right, God bless you all, and have a great May crowning on Friday. Bye.